I propose to further consolidate, Speaker Sir, the gains in order to make India a more attractive FDI destination. A. The government will examine suggestions of further opening up of FDI in aviation, in media, animation, ABGC and insurance sectors in consultation with all stakeholders. 100% foreign direct investment will be permitted for insurance intermediaries. Local sourcing norms will be eased for the FDI in single brand retail sector. Single brand retail sector. It's high time India not only gets integrated into global value chain of production of goods and services, but also become part of the global financial system to mobilize global savings, mostly institutionalized in pension, insurance, sovereign wealth funds and so on. The government is contemplating organizing an annual global investors meet in India using National Infrastructure Investment Fund as the anchor to get all three sets of global players, top industrialists, corporate leaders, top pension insurance sovereign wealth funds, top pension insurance and sovereign wealth funds, and top digital technology and venture funds also. An important determinant of attracting cross-border investment, Speaker Sir, is availability of investable stock to the foreign portfolio investors. This issue assumes greater significance in view of the gradual shift from stock-targeted investments towards passive investment, whereby funds track global indices composition, of which depends upon available floating stock. Accordingly, I propose to increase the statutory limit for FDI investment in a company from 24% to sectoral foreign investment limit, with option given to the concerned corporates to limit it to a lower threshold. FDIs will be permitted to subscribe to listed debt securities issued by the REITs or the InvITs. Even though India is the world's top remittance recipient, NRI investment in Indian capital markets is comparatively less. With a view to provide NRIs with seamless access to Indian equities, I propose to merge the NRI portfolio investment scheme route with the foreign portfolio investment route. New and innovative financial instruments have been launched in the last 5 years, like Infrastructure Investment Trust, the InvITs, which I referred to a minute ago, Real Estate Investment Trust, the REITs, which I referred to a minute ago, as well as models like Toll Operate Transfer, the TOT, as part of the Brownfield Asset Modernization Strategy for augmenting infrastructure investment. India has had a reasonable success in brownfield asset monetization, and several InvITs and one REIT transaction have already been completed. Additionally, the National Highways Authority, NHAI, carried out one TOT transaction as well. The cumulative resources garnered through these instruments and model, Speaker Sir, exceed 24,000 crores of rupees. India has emerged as a major space power with the technology and ability to launch satellites and other space products at globally low cost level. Time has come to harness this ability commercially. A public sector enterprise, namely New Space India Limited, NSIL, has been incorporated as a new commercial arm of the Department of Space, to tap the benefits of the research and development carried out in space research organization. The company will spearhead commercialization of various space products, including production of launch vehicles, transfer of technologies, and marketing of space products. Sir, I've all the while spoken about the various means through which we can, at a macro level, reaching the $5 trillion target. Now, I would just confine myself to talking about Grameen Bharat, the rural India, the various steps which we'll take towards strengthening our economy. Mahatma Gandhiji had said, the soul of India lives in its villages. This year, even as we are marking the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi, I submit that our government keeps Antyodaya at the core of all its efforts. At the center of everything that we do, we keep Gaon, Garib or Kisan. Matlab, Gaon, Garib or Kisan Kendra Bindu hai hamare har ek karyakram mein. Honorable Prime Minister's two mega initiatives of Ujjwala Yojana and Saubhagya Yojana have transformed the lives of every rural family, dramatically improving ease of their living. Household access to clean cooking gas has seen an unprecedented expansion through provision of more than 7 crore LPG connections. All villages and almost 100% households across the country have been provided with electricity.